Do you know when you'll be done using your screwdriver?
Well, we have to finish this dance floor.
We don't even have the right piece of wood yet.
It could take days.
I hope not.
We'd really like to borrow your screwdriver sometime.
Yeah, sure.
But not until after we get this dance floor finished.
Are you finished using your screwdriver yet?
No, not until we've made a proper square dance floor.
Would you be willing to sell us your screwdriver?
No, we might need it to work on this dance floor. Maybe later when it's finished.
How big a piece of wood did they say they needed for this?
5 feet by 5 feet.
Oh, sure. I remember now. How big was that piece of wood supposed to be again?
5 feet by 5 feet.
Oh, right. I'm hungry. Are you hungry?
Not right now.
What size wood did they say they needed?
5 feet by 5 feet.
Oh, yeah.
My name's Freddy Fish, and this is my best pal, Luther.
Howdy, kids. Folks call me Sahara Swim.
We're helping my cousin Calico. Her hogfish were taken by some rustlers.
Rustlers, eh? Well, I wouldn't know about that. I've known a few wrestlers in my day, but no rustlers to speak of.
How do you get the name Sahara Slim?
Why, I once crossed the Sahara Desert in nothing but a glass full of water. It took 3 weeks, but I made it.
Wow! Is that true?
Mostly.
Are you from around here, Slim?
Nope. Ooh, just passing through on my way to Monte Carlo, where I plan to hit it big.
Hit what big?
Well, now, I guess I hadn't quite thought that part out yet. Say, have you kids ever been to Cucamonga?
No.
Well, I was traveling through there once when I was set upon by a pack of wild blubberfish.
What do you mean, set upon?
I mean, they were sitting right on me so I couldn't get up. Heavy fish they are.
What did you do?
Well, I tricked them into having a breath-holding contest with me. They all took deep breaths, and when they were full of air, they just floated away.
Is that true?
Mostly.
Everyone seems really friendly around here, except the rustlers, of course.
Do you think those construction workers will ever finish that dance floor?
Not if they have to get the wood themselves. Did you know that warm water floats on top of cold water, but ice floats on top of warm water?
Huh.
Could you use a purple sea urchin?
Oh, I'm pretty well fixed right now. But thanks for offering.
Sure. Whatever you're cooking smells good.
It's Sahara Slim's special super stew. My own recipe. Oh. Not quite ready. You know, young fella, you remind me of a crocodile I met once up around Winnemucca.
I do?
Yep. He was green, just like you. Swallowed me whole, he did.
Wow! How did you escape?
Well, I just sprinkled some pepper on him, and he sneezed me right back out again. Say, maybe that's where I left my pepper shaker.
Did that really happen?
Most of it.
You've been lots of places, haven't you, Slim?
Oh, yeah. Abilene, Bogalusa, Chattanooga, I've been there. Once I was even in two places at the same time. But that's kind of a long story.
Tell us another story about your adventures.
One time in Pocatello, my buddy Two Carboni and I got hold of a turtle that laid golden eggs. I didn't think they tasted any too good, though. So I let Monty keep the turtle.
Really? Wow!
Say, is that a bandana you've got there?
Sure is. Very handy. Although sometimes I wish I had something sturdier to carry my gear in.
What's in the stew?
It's mostly kelp root and tumbleweed branches. Plus, a few secret ingredients. There's 3 cups of paprika.
Isn't that kind of a lot?
Not for a super stew.
What else is in the stew?
Secret ingredients.
Like what?
If I told you, they wouldn't be very secret now, would they?
Are you sure you won't tell me what else is in the stew?
Can you keep a secret?
Sure.
Me too.
Please tell us what's in the super stew.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
Because it's a secret?
Because I don't know. I bought the stew from a fellow in Monterey last spring, and he said the ingredients were secret.
You've been cooking the stew since last spring?
Well, it has to simmer a while to mellow the flavors.
Is the stew ready yet?
Oh, almost.
Is the stew ready yet?
Oh, almost.
You've certainly had an interesting life, haven't you, Slim?
Once, near Amarillo, I wrestled a bullfish to the ground with one fin tied behind my back. I told him down was sideways and he fell right over. Not too bright, these bullfish.
Lot more westerny if I had a good hat to wear.
We'll get you one. Don't worry.
That's pretty neat the way you can carry your stuff in a bandana.
Oh, I reckon. But most days I just wish I had a suitcase like everybody else.
Do you think you could let us have your bandana for a while?
No, I reckon I'll need it until I can get a suitcase or something to carry my things in.
Do you have any more good stories to tell?
I met the Queen of the North Sea once. At a rodeo down in Tonopah. She was in disguise, but I recognized her straight off. She knighted me on the condition that I not tell anybody. Uh-oh. Oh, well.
Gee!
You've certainly had an interesting life, haven't you, Slim?
Well, let's see. I was once in a hollering contest against the legendary Paul Grunion. I beat him by swallowing a bullhorn.
Really?
Is the stew ready yet?
Oh, almost.
Do you have any more good stories to tell?
They once put my picture in the newspaper by mistake, instead of a picture of that famous bank robber, Fast Willie Salmon. I had to swim all over the county and buy up every copy before anyone else could get one.
Boy, oh boy, was I tired.
Gee! Tell us another story about your adventures.
Do you know, I invented the method they use for pouring soda underwater.
Yep, I'd be a wealthy fish if that eel Cyrus Fizzlebig hadn't beaten me to the patent office. Oh well.
Wow!
Looks like your bandana's getting a little frayed around the edges.
Yep.
Eventually, I figure it'll wear out altogether.
Someday, I'd like to get something a little sturdier to carry my gear around in.
Do you have any more good stories to tell?
I met the Queen of the North Sea once at a rodeo down in Tonopah. She was in disguise, but I recognized her straight off. She knighted me on the condition that I not tell anybody. Uh-oh. Oh, well.
Really? Wow! I think that's pretty neat the way you can carry your stuff in a bandana.
Oh, I reckon. But most days I just wish I had a suitcase like everybody else.
Thank you.